The best way to blur a background in a photo is by using a wide aperture when you take it. But what if you can't control your camera aperture, or you don't achieve enough blur and you can't repeat the shot? In this video, I'll share a quick and easy way to blur the background in a photo using Lightroom. To do this, there are two problems we need to overcome. The first is how to make an accurate selection of our subject so that we don't blur it. Now that Adobe has released the new selection and masking tools in Lightroom, there is an easy way. When I first click the masking icon, I can choose one of the masking and selection tools. The easiest option by far is the new Select Subject tool. This works great with most photos where there's an obvious subject in the frame. In this photo, it makes a precise selection of the man, which you can see highlighted with the red overlay. If we look at the mask panel, you can see a thumbnail of the mask that's been created. Then, below this is the Select Subject tool, which was used to select the man. It's possible to apply multiple selection tools to the same mask to refine it using the Add and Subtract buttons. We'll be looking at an example of doing this shortly. It's also a good idea to rename the selections to something more meaningful if you're going to use multiple tools on the same mask. For this example, I'll double-click the selection and then enter the new name in the dialog. The next step is to invert the selection because we want our adjustment to apply to the background and not the man. To reverse the selection, move your mouse pointer over the selection item in the mask panel. Three dots then appear to the right, which you can click. This displays a pop-up menu where you can select the invert option. You should then see the red overlay inverted. Now any adjustments I apply will be applied to the background and not to the man. Earlier I said that we face two problems and we've already dealt with the first, which was making an accurate selection. The second problem we have though is how to blur something because Lightroom doesn't have a blur adjustment. Or at least it didn't when I recorded this video. Fortunately, there are a few adjustments that can help us. The first is a sharpness slider. When I move this to the left, it sets a negative value, removing any sharpening that I'd set in Lightroom's detail panel. But when I move it beyond a setting of minus 50, it begins to blur detail in the selection and not just remove the sharpening. Let's zoom in and I'll turn the adjustment off and on using the switch at the bottom of the adjustment panel. You can see the label on the parcel is being blurred by the adjustments I've applied. The next adjustment that we can try is the texture slider. When I move that to minus 100, you can see that it blurs out the detail in the background. This slider is quite effective and like the sharpness slider, you can move it all the way to the left with reasonable results. The third slider we can use for blurring is clarity. When I move this to the left, you can see that it creates a soft blurry effect. The only problem that I find though when using negative clarity is that it produces more of a glow effect than a blur. Because of this, you might want to limit its use to probably no more than minus 50. It's also possible to increase the strength of the blurring by duplicating the mask. Just move your mouse pointer over the thumbnail in the masks panel and you'll see three dots appear to the right. Click these and you can then select the duplicate option. If I turn all the adjustments off and on at the top of the panel, you can see the effect they're having. Now let's look at another example where the Select Subject option doesn't work quite so well. As before, I'll start by using the Select Subject option under the masking icon. This makes a good selection of the man, but it's spilling over into some surrounding areas. We also have this odd-looking selection of the laptop and book. What we need to do is clean up these areas of the mask using other selection tools. But first, I'm going to invert the selection as before. Now I can choose to add to the selection by clicking the Add button. When I click the Add button, you can see the option to use different tools displayed. I'll choose the Brush tool because the areas I want to include have irregular shapes. For the settings, I'll use a slight feather on the brush. I'll also have the flow down at about 50% with 100% opacity. And importantly, I'm using the Auto Mask option to help refine the selection as I paint. The 50% flow setting means that I need to make a few passes with the brush to build up the selection. If you spot an area where the selection spills over into another area where you don't want it, use the undo command. It's easier than trying to correct the selection with the erase brush. After making the selection, I can apply the adjustments again. The real secret to being able to blur a background in Lightroom is to produce the best possible selection, which is the subject of my recent book. There's also an Adobe Camera Raw version if you prefer that to Lightroom. Now, sometimes when you duplicate a mask to make the effect stronger, the edges of the selection can begin to look a little false. If you see this happening, use the subtract option with the brush tool. You can then paint around the edge of the object to improve the edge. Whilst the new select subject option makes complex selections easy, there is an alternative. In this video, I demonstrate how to create a complex selection using the Lightroom brush tool in just a couple of clicks. If you're using an older version of Lightroom, you don't want to miss this, but you can also use the same technique in Lightroom today. Now, if you haven't already done so, please do take a moment to subscribe and don't forget to share this video with others. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon in another video.